What's up, everybody? I wanted to make a quick kind of farewell video to the Terminator platform and kind of bring some light to some of the differences between going from a Terminator setup to a HP, or in my case, a Dominator. Terminator's been great for me. I've ran it for a little over 2 years now. I've gone plenty of fast on it with a basic turbo setup, but I'm starting to kind of outgrow it. So this video will just kind of go over some of the differences as far as physical stuff that you have to purchase, software differences, and then if you got any questions, make sure to ask, and then if you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Alright, so let's look at the actual physical hardware here. So here's my Terminator ECU. This is not a max because I'm running a Turbo 400 trans. Hold it up here. See, size-wise, it is tiny in comparison to the Dominator. So starting off on the left, you can see that these two connectors on both are the same. That's going to be your J1A and J1B between the two. You can carry over your wire harness from that, but when we look at the actual software side, you'll notice that there are some differences in their capabilities. Power plugs are the same, so that's going to be something you get to retain. But then you'll notice, obviously, the Terminator is missing all the I/O channels that you have on the Dominator ECU. One thing that you'll need to purchase if you want to use those is going to be additional plugs. I bought mine through ProWire, but you can get them through Holley and a bunch of other vendors. They come unterminated, so basically as you set up your software, you'll wire your pins, you know, based on your needs. Next one I want to talk about is oxygen sensors. This was one that was somewhat unclear when I first made the switch. Both of these are Bosch O2 sensors. You'll notice that the Holley Terminator uses a adapter harness. This basically converts this 6-wire plug to this 8-wire plug. On the Dominator Bosch setup, you just go straight to the 8-wire plug. So you will need to buy a new wideband O2 sensor. There is NTK and Bosch available for the Dominator. The Terminator one is not a direct carryover. You may be able to plug it in, but from what I've read, it's not a apples to apples use. For the sake of demonstration, I have the two different wideband O2 sensors next to each other. Depending on your setup, you need to understand that there is a shortened length when you're not using the adapter plug. So if your wiring's tight, you may need to work on extending it to make sure that you have enough length. So the last of the hardware changes, if you're a laptop guy like me and you're using your laptop, I had this current performance CAN to USB cable. That was the interface basically to link my PC to the Terminator ECU. When you run the Dominator, there is a mini USB to standard USB adapter. This plugs directly into the ECU in the blue port here. From what I've seen over the years, you gotta be very careful with this. It's pretty easy to bend or break the connector. I have a hardwired USB port on my dash, so I will just basically hook this up once and then never have to touch it again. So when it comes to software, you can see the left is Terminator X V2, the right is V6 of Holley EFI. On the forefront, it looks pretty similar. I'm gonna just open up to global configs that I have been working with. Software is pretty similar. If you look at like the ECU tab, for example, you know, a lot of stuff is going to be basically carryover. There is no converter between Terminator X global files and HP and Dominator. So there are videos on YouTube. Basically, what you got to do is split screen kind of like this. Go tab by tab and carry over everything that you have. You'll notice in some ways, like just on this engine parameters tab, there are some differences. Like on this one, we have like the wideband O2 sensors up top. You know, with the Terminator X, you can see obviously 4.9 Bosch is the only allowable. When you go to the Dominator HP, you have the difference between NTK or Bosch. Same with like your fuel injector information. Terminator's locked, that's got the graph on there. For the HP and Dominator, you have to actually click it and go to a different tab. A lot of it's carryover. There are some differences that I'd like to point out. When you go to pin map, the biggest one that I wanted to point out is that on the Terminator software, you can see that by default, I think B12 on the J1 connector is your electric fan, which is a ground output. If you look at B12 as an output on the other software, it does not have ground as an option. So for my particular tune, I moved to B12 on J2 instead of J1. So there will be some physical wiring to change on that. But at least with my current tune on my original Terminator software, my boost solenoid output wiring carried over with no differences. I was able to reuse my rev limit 1, my trans brake, dome pressure, bump, scramble, and flex fuel input. So my J1 connector on the input side was unchanged, which is quite nice. So overall, I've really enjoyed using the Terminator platform. You know, for a street car or a more basic track car, it's a great platform for being budget friendly. Unfortunately for me, there was just some software limitations and I/O limitations that, you know, I really wanted to take advantage of. So if anybody's got any questions, make sure to ask. If you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Thanks.